as well as the design of the Mai.
Of the finance.
Today we are going to introduce some.
首先呢，我们会介绍一下为什么我们的 KBS 机型它需要一个巡检这样的东西，然后我们再会介绍一下一个比较普通的巡检 service 它是怎么样构成的。然后我们再会去完整介绍一下一个包含自愈的巡检系统它怎么样设计的。最后我们会展望一下未来，我们以及我们下一步工作。
Then we're going to talk about our future works.
我们先看一下我们目前碰到的一个较大比较大规模执行的一个现状。第一个，我们先看一下 load。我们的 load 里面目前的节点已经是超过一万台了。那这个是一个非常大的一个机型，而这个机型呢，里面所有的节点它会有各种各样的一个硬件，从 CPU 内存、硬盘各种各样的都有，比如 CPU 它有32、64、或者96核，内存有64G， 也有512G 的，包括一些其他的一些 GPU 的一些硬件，或者来打 TJ 的，它都是有非常多的一些硬件规格。除了硬件规格的不同，它还有非常多的软件的不同。第一个就是我们的 OS 的一些版本啊，还有一些它这上面的节点会有不同版本的。然后除了 Node 还下面会讲一下 Port。我们的 Port 单机型这个上万台节点的 Port， 上万台节点的 KBS 里面，它包含了超过10万个节点的 Port。这 Port 又主要是分为两种类型，一种类型就是我们普通的跑长期任务的一些 Port， 还有个就是比较生命周期较短的，我们这边称之它为 job 的一些服务。那为了构建这数十万个 Port， 那我们在实践中会有非常多的很多的这个数量会上百的，那同时对应的它的用户自定义资源其实都有然后也是上百的。那你可以看到在这么多资源和很多的情况下，那其实我们的 KBS 其实更我们可以看到 KBS 对我们的承诺，或者是给我们的希望是它保持一个一致性，所有的 controller 会将所有的用户自定义资源赋予到一定的状态，但是整个机型的一个所有的资源真的达到了它所说的一致性吗？其实答案是很明显的，就是在大规模执行的情况下，很难达到所有的资源或者所有的一些状态都达到我们自己的期望。我们看一下典型的一个例子，第一个就是 IP 通路，这是我们在实践中偶尔碰到的。IP 通路这个问题就比较严重，它会造成我们的一个服务完全中断，会引起比较严重的生产故障，特别是一旦在核心应用出现这种问题，那肯定会有这个问题。还另外一方面就是当用户 source， 就是相当于这些资源已经没有用了，起码在生产上你没有任何流量，它发的东西你还在执行里面，那这个其实是第一个是资源浪费，第二个会导致你的扩容不出来，那涉及到相关的就是一个 pod， pod 是属于资源的，而是属于那些计算资源，那还有 PV， 它就属于存储资源，这些浪费都会导致其实你的 KBS 机体内的数据是不一致的。还有这上面提到的是内部的，那其实 KBS 周边会有非常多的外部系统，比如说 CMPP， 那你的一些 pod 信息没有同步到 CMPP 这些道，也会导致你的外部的系统一些无法正常工作，这是生产中会碰到。还有一个 IPM， 那你的所有的 IPM 系统，IPM
是 elevator is similar to CRD 啊 CMDB。
那我们前面提到了一些 case， 其实我想表达一个意思，就是我们需要一种方法去深入我们 KBS 机型，然后这个知道我们目前进行的一些不一致的情况，那我们这边也称为巡检。
So what we call it is the inspection。
我们这边，那我们需要一个什么样的一个巡检的服务呢？这边简单介绍一下三点，第一点就是高效性， 这边说了一下，我们这个节点是有上只有上万台规模的，同时它有十万个规模的 pod， 那同时我们还上百种的自定义节点。那如果这个自定义节点都会每个 pod 都有的话，那其实这个量也是非常大，会有几十万上上百万这种。这第一个是高效性，第二个是可扩展性。但我们的团队其实是跨了好几个团队，好几个 group 的。那我们这个巡检如果应用到整个 CBS 级行业的时候，就需要要支持多个团队，同时呢还要支持上百个我们的巡检巡检点。这个巡检点就可以包含前面的第一个就是 IT 冲突，或者是 Pod 当令了一些其他的一些资源。还有就是第三点是可观测性，因为我们的巡检出来的结果是为了解决，那我们肯定是要看呢。其实这里的力量，第一个是 auditing， 还有第二是 monitoring， 那后面可以看一下我们怎么做的。好，那我们前面说一下一个巡检，一个巡检服务，需要你的东西。这边的话，我们在实践过程中有分了几个阶段，那我们现在主要介绍一下现在我们这种设计。
I want to introduce the first version. So this is the design of the version one.
那我们先说一下我们在第一个阶段的时候，这个模型是我们一个巡检服务，它是一个单进程的，这是一个进程里面的一个一些组件的一个示意图。可以看到第一个它的核心逻辑之一，第一个是 provider 是我们巡检的数据起源，可以多的第一个就是 provider 内部的一些资源，第二个是比如说我们去节点上取一些把容器的数据取出来，那第三个就是第三个是其实指一类，就是说其他的一些都各列出来的，包括你的 IPM 的数据、CMB 的数据都可以作为 provider 提供给我们巡检。第二个核心是 它是个 queue， 相当于我们的巡检任务是非常多的，就前面说了我们的资源 pod 都会非常多，那其实它的跑任务可能是上百万级别的，那它是可以有的任务，有可以有的任务都得去跑。这里是这个就相当于你的任务不可能是一直在跑，它肯定是有一个出发的机制，这里出发机制第一个是定时的跑，第二个是人为的手动出发，还有这个就是相当于通过外部的事件去自动出发。这里 output 这是我前面说的我作为可观测性，我们在第一个版本中我们是用可观测性和 graph 去做展示的，当然我们的 output 其实还有另外一个平台去展示一些我们关注的一些巡检结果。那整个整体的工作流程其实之间都有话我们看跟大家说一下。第一个这个是起点，它会去它的目的是往这个任务队列去加一个任务，可以是比如说这个任务是关注一个 IP 的，那它把 IP 搞完后，那这个 IP 就会去根据我们的 provider 去取数据，计算出结果，将结果送出到普罗米斯或者是其他的地方，然后后面做展示，这就是简单的流程。但这个不是做过简化的，有些很多其他东西没有关系，但是它的核心思路就是以 provider 的方式去提供我们的巡检的基础数据，然后再通过这个方式将需要跑的任务加到任务队列，再通过任务队列的方式将所有的任务执行完，最终把这样所有的数据导出去。那我前面说这是第一个版本，所以可想而知的会有第二版本。那为什么会有第二版本？我们先介绍一下前面这个第一个版本会有存在哪些问题。我们前面说过，这个是单进程跑。那其实我们在实践中跑的时候，就碰到一个问题，就是路由器的性能的问题。因为我们的任务非常大，再加上我们的出发。任务种类非常多，然后执行的资源又非常的多，导致我们的性能会出现一个瓶颈。同时，由于我们任务量非常大，那有些任务它，我们的任务稍微那个任务队列会出现这个争抢的问题，会导致有些 经验的结果不出来不及时，会造成一些比如说用，比如说开发商在看的时候，他需要检查某些东西是否正常，那结果可能极少没有，那这个任务这边是我们就资源之前是一个问题。
Then we have to face the problems of the resource conflicts among different tasks. And then also, since it's a single pod to the design, so that means that each inspection were designed in one pod, and then one pod for one cluster. And then with the expansions of the clusters, and this version couldn't match with the demand because this version is not scalable. And then also for our first version, and then we only considered it as an internal cycle, so it's not of it's in the layer of the generosity. So based on our version 1, we do not want to create another new version, and we actually want to base our inspections on the existing platform. So we have the second version, in version 2. And now I want to talk about the advantages of magnetics as the circular component. The biggest advantage is we enjoy from it, and it is the serverless, because we talk about the issues of performance. And however, by using kinetics, it can help us to scale our performance. And also, kinetics
is
a support the cloud event. And the cloud event can actually provide the multiple triggers for us. It can be kinetic event, it can be
the GitHub
event.
And the
cloud event is actually the general event model. And also, we do not want to only provide an internal service. We want to provide in a general framework to everybody. Of course, the preliminary version of the model is the same, but we want to provide a framework. So here,
as
you can see, based on the kinetic, now we have actually established a new inspection model. And so the core logic actually doesn't change. Provider still provides our data for inspection. And the task here, and already become
the kinetic
based.
And
the point, and the event is actually the previous trigger, and which is the cause of the massive
hook.
And now I want to briefly introduce this process, the process of this first of the inspection. So suppose that we have a class in the event, so when the event happens, and it can actually and send the task to the task queue, and so the task can subscribe and connective event, and so when you receive the event, and it can actually compare the event and then calculate the result. And also, the cloud event of connecting will be sent back. And after sending back, the connective is going to pass the message in the queue again. And there is an external action, and which subscribes the result of the inspection, and then sending out to the external system. So that means that if there is a problem, then be identified during the inspection, and then or maybe some special event happens from the application, and we can easily and receive those information. And you can see in the version 2, and it basically solves a lot of the tough issues of performance and the scalability. So we can further improve this and make it as a framework to share with the community. So this is the very brief introduction of the inspection service.
In the powerful of the inspections, there is more to be done, and here I only introduce one inspection service. And this is just a beginning point for an inspection system, but based on this beginning point, we can add a lot of other powerful jobs. So in our practices, my colleague Chen Jie will introduce you this methodology. Thank you.
接下来由我来介绍下一部分的内容。
Thank you.And now I will hand over and to introduce you the following part. And just now, Martin Jin had introduced to you in the large scale Kubernetes clusters how to practice the inspections. And there is a general inspection service to be adopted, and we can identify more abnormal situations. And we also talked about how to introduce this inspection service. And today we had.Embraced the service fees, and we had also improved the performance and solved the problem of scalability. So the inspection service is only the beginning point of departure. And next, I'd like to introduce how to build a complete inspection system based on that point of departure.
So
first, let me summarize what my colleague had observed. First, you would find that what he is talking about is in a large-scale Kubernetes clusters, what are the infrastructures? That is the server, the network, the storage, and the stability between all of those businesses have a big gap. So where does this gap come from? We also know that very often we have our own monitoring systems in the clusters. And the monitoring system can identify some abnormalities, but it cannot solve all of those problems. Usually it can only solve part of the problems, and the problem of consistency cannot be solved by the monitor. So we are thinking about can we use the inspections to connect all of those structures and to improve the stability of the businesses and to fill the gap. And we can provide a comprehensive guarantee for the stability in the Kubernetes systems. So based on these motives, we can think about the features of the Kubernetes. There are multiple problems for the monitoring systems. For example, the Kubernetes will collect the information from the agent, and there is a distortion of those information and how to identify the problems of the monitor itself, and we can use inspection service to do that. So apart from the Kubernetes clusters and the monitoring systems, we have a lot of dependent services. And for example, my colleague had told you the CMDB and IPM, and all of those systems will have a data set, and these data more or less have relationships with the Kubernetes data. For example, the IP, which is very common for all of those systems, such as the IPAM and OPS. Most of those operation and management maintenance systems will have the IP. And when there is an inconsistency or a conflict, we need to know about the root cause, and we want to maintain the consistency. So the consistency issue had been limited to Kubernetes.And if we want to start from a larger scope of the closed loop, we can have a better design of the system. So based on Kubernetes, cloud native architecture, the orchestration of the Kubernetes has fundamental changes compared with the very beginning. For example, in terms of the API, we had a lot of changes. And before, based on the scope, the API is imperative. And in the Kubernetes structure,It's declarative. And before, the operation and maintenance is based on the VM or the subcontainers. But now, it has been evolved to a flexible containers in part. So the operation and maintenance or management model had been completely changed. And before, we only had an adjustment of the resource allocation. And in Kubernetes, a lot of those jobs had been penetrated down, such as the service finding. And we also have a lot of resource schedulings, many changes. Apart from the issues I had pointed out, we also had made so many changes. And in Kubernetes, maybe in the initial stage, we need to focus on different kind of issues, and we need to think about what are the key issues we need to solve for Kubernetes, and in the core orchestration systems, what are the values and what are the boundaries. So first, with understanding of these root causes, we can have a better design of the whole system. On the layer is our infrastructure.
And
what are the boundaries for the infrastructure? If you're running on the cloud, then cloud is your infrastructure. The stability of the Kubernetes would rely on the stability of the infrastructure. So we can use the monitoring and the inspection of the cloud of Kubernetes as an input for the cloud, and then on the top we can see the part of the containers, and this is also important for the inspections, but it will not intrude the logics of operations. For example, there are a lot of the e-commerce trade systems, and we can have an asset loss inspections, and we also have the auditing systems, and these are not included here. So from another perspective, we can see that the differences between the alerting system and the monitoring system. So if you're responsible for the management, then you would be very familiar with this concept. So the monitoring system will base on the metrics or the other indicators to make decisions whether this system is normal or not. But the alerting system would have its own data collection mechanisms, and it can create an independent closed loop. So the data source of the monitoring system has a very monologue type of the data. What about the inspection systems? For example, you should first set up some expectations, and this kind of expectation can be reflected on the target or indicators, and then you can have a regular check of the system and to decide whether you need repairment or not. So actually, the alerting system can use the data provided by the monitoring system, and we also have some of the other dependent data.
So,
this is more facing for the target and the user.
So, in the alerting system,
no matter it's about the monitoring system or the inspection system, we can use them to identify the abnormalities, but we need a pathway to show the abnormality to the people. So, we have a lot of operators, those developers, responsible for the maintenance, and the core for the alerting system is to notify people about the abnormality. So we had talked a lot about the infrastructures and the boundaries of the infrastructures, and we also talked about the differences between the alerting system and the monitoring system, and then we can take a look at the components of the Kubernetes inspection system. The first component is the node, the Docker-D, Pod-D, and Pod-D is an financial or the Alibaba container platform. So we need to run the container, and this is the basis for the successful scheduling of the Kubernetes. If there is a problematic environment, then it's impossible for you to run the containers. And when you have multiple versions of the containers, and you don't have the right environment for that, it's impossible for you to run them appropriately. So this is the most core inspection, and the second is the Kubernetes core circuit, and we can have the automatic launch of the pods. So the core circuit is about the single machine and the EDCD. So because of this core content, we can generate some of the containers, and we need to think about whether it has been meeting up to our expectations. And I had been emphasizing on the external dependent systems, and we also need to run inspection for that. And in the runtime of the container, we also need to have the inspection such as the networking and the storage, whether they had been meeting your expectations. And the third part is about the incidences. And Kubernetes has a lot of incidences, and the peripheral systems also have a lot of incidences. And you need to connect these two, and you need to find out what is the root cause for the errors.
好，那当然我说我们说刚才说了，就是说我们已经圈定了这个巡检的范围。So
now we know the scope of inspections, and we know the values of inspections. And actually, when there is some abnormalities detected by the inspections, it is a very valuable information and can help you to answer many questions. You would know, well, these are the issues of the system, and we need to provide solutions for that. So just now, I had talked about the importance of the abnormalities identified by the inspections, and they can help us to make the decisions plans and to have more analysis, and you could know the underlying problems, and then you can exclude those problems and to fix those issues. And more importantly, when there is an issue, we can very quickly identify the causes for that. And in this process, it naturally occurs to us, we need to make repairment. Maybe you can say that, well, I can use the controller to fix it. But in a large scale cluster, it's impossible for you to do it completely manually. So we want to do it automatically. And then inspection and fixing should be collected and integrated. So we need to form a closed loop. So how? In this closed loop of inspection, first we need data. And just now I have been emphasizing on the provider of the data and how to provide services with the provider. And in the collection of the data, which you can see at the bottom, we are using the Kubernetes community open source export mechanism. And the Kubernetes export can create a not bot and event, and we have the metrics, and we have the standalone machine supervisors, and the standalone data can be input. And with this data, we need to think about storage, because the format of the data are different, and we have a huge amount of the data, and the metrics will be existed in a TSDB, and the event will be stored as well, and the metadata such as mod and pod will be stored in a database so that we can better retrieve them. And then it comes to today's theme, and that is the data analysis. So inspection is about data analysis. And we can have the inspection diagnosis and the calculation. When there is an abnormality, we can run the monitoring and to fix it. So we have to fix engines and to have the recovery. So with so many capabilities, we can provide API to connect it to the top products. And with those capabilities, bottom up, we hope that for the collection, storage of the data analysis and monitoring and the self-healing, we need the systematic management capabilities. For example, I can give you self-healing as an example, and we can use multiple tools to fix it. But actually, self-healing is a very dangerous thing. For example, when the container has a problem, then you need to delete the previous container. And if you had identified a bug, what should you do? Then the whole cluster is in danger. The most dangerous thing is that you had deleted the whole cluster, and this is quite risky. So you have to have the security measures. We have the common adoptions, common practices such as the throttling, and then you also need to have the fuselage. So you need to prevent the further unnecessary deletions, and you should also have the backups, and then you need to have certain strategies. And inside our company, we have very comprehensive self-healing mechanisms. With that, you can better control the execution of self-healing and control the risk. So just now, we had talked about how to create a closed-loop inspection system. And finally, the purpose of the inspection is to enable the users to better run the system. And we have multiple developers involved in this process, and all of us are our users. So how to empower these users? How to allow them to constantly integrate the development systems. And I can give you an example. And we use Prometheus as a basis for the monitoring. And if you have been using Prometheus before, then you know that we can use the Grafner and the default UI to have a configuration of the monitoring, and it's the same for the inspection system. For example, we can develop our own products or a set of the products, and then we can have a configuration and management for the clusters. We have multiple users, many users, and we have multiple categories of the clusters for the users, and some of them maintenance the system by themselves, and some are maintained by ourselves. So for each of the clusters, we have different situations, and sometimes in this cluster, we need this item, but it's not needed in another cluster. So and nominated value for, or the threshold for each of the cluster are different. We need a more user-friendly way.
And also, as my colleague just mentioned, to make an inspection frame in our work, we hope that we, because in the past we use the SDK, and however, we really hope that we can just use the image, and if they can provide the image, and then I can actually exclude it from the image. And also, in the longer future, I really hope that I can use the ADS, which it can be done with the YAML files, with the several lines of the code, and I can actually customize the inspection. And I just showed the overall system design. And now I really need to show you some real cases. So you can
see
what is the systematic inspection. With all of this framework and dashboards, and I can actually give you a screenshot to see. So this is one of the dashboards. So in order to make the operators better understanding the system's risks, and we actually categorize very important inspections, and we show all of the good inspections on it. So if there is no troubles at all, and they will be the colors according to them, and the numbers on the screen. And however, if there were some errors or if there were some abnormal situations, then you can already read it from the screen. So when you provide a lot of service, and you can actually document with a lot of different kinds of the system. And I want to talk about our future. And inspections actually play a very important role for the KPS system. And so what about the future of the inspection? And I really hope that we can use the inspection service and to form the closed loop. And within this closed loop, the data will be the foundation.
And
so this data platform is going to integrate all of the data of the Kubernetes. And so we also need to connect it with computing framework or computing platform to further expand our computing capacity. And also we can use those very typical algorithms to improve our capacity. So based on our own engine, based on on our own algorithm service, and we use our own engine because our engines is actually connected with the Kubernetes, and so we can better make adjustments to the system. And also through our management control, we can better control the closed loop. So finally, we are going to management build in this AIOps driven self-healing inspection system. So this is the end of my sharing. Thank you very much. Any questions?